Hi, my name is Pedro and this is All My Function. This is the video number 9 of a series I'm creating to teach you about data visualizations. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to glue together React and D3. It's very simple and actually you can make everything work as it should using only vanilla D3, but it gets really cool when you implement it with React because then you can add a few things that are good about the framework. And you can use things like on-click events and syntax that you could only use on React components. Let's see how it works. So this is going to be a little bit different from the rest of the videos because I'm going to use VS Code and not Code Sandbox because I feel a little bit more, confident using VS Code doing this kind of stuff. I'm not going to delete these boilerplate code like the test and etc. I'm just going to use the app.js that using side because that's everything I need. All right, so as you guys know, we have here, and I'm going to copy and paste what we've got. The whole D3 bar chart that I've created on the last video. I could use it all the way it is right now. But you're going to see that, for example, I have these things here on the data join. And I have the get body when, select body when doing this kind of stuff. And I shouldn't select the body or actually a class or even an ID. I could actually use a reference. That is what React uses to do things like this, to append stuff and etc. So first things first, let's create then a reference that is going to be used with useRef. That is the React hook to create references. And what we're going to do is basically pass a ref to this div and that's 99% of the work. The rest is basically create a use effect. And this data set is going to come from here. And by the way, I need to install D3. So yarn add D3. So I'm going to import everything as D3 from D3, the same way. Remove this comment. And this is my data set, right? The only thing that's going to change on this chart is the data set. So if I go to the dependency array here, I can add the data. So if the data changes, because I'm not mutating, blah, 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 but that's just because I made it a constant here, but it usually comes from the server. All right, so I can define like the margin outside because I don't need it to change. The width and height too. Cool, and now let's start with these ones. As this is something that changes if the data changes and all the rest is actually, I'm gonna copy this one and put inside of the use effect. I'm gonna remove these comments for now. So now this one. Oops. And then when I select the body here, I'm going to actually select the reference and then append the SVG and then do the rest. And I think, if I'm correct, that that's everything I need to do, but I'm not. Because of this thing, of the three selection, but I actually think that, the ref here is actually not the reference itself, is the current. Yeah, and it kind of works. Like, that's it. That's the way that you would probably pass a D3 chart using vanilla JS to a React application. I know that in some cases, it's really good to have D3 working directly with React. It kind of mixes, in my opinion, the imperativity with the explicitivity of both worlds. And I actually don't quite like the way that it works. So in my opinion, I prefer to use a library called VizX to create my charts. And that's what I'm going to learn on the next video. And yeah, I think that's it. If you like the video, please subscribe and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.